are doing a very important project. We've already done our composting over here, so our soil's ready. We've already gotten our biointensive garden going. We've gotten our self-pesticiding plants ready. We've planted our seeds, and now we're ready to move into stage three for our producing your own organic food, and that is building a barn for our animals. We have two types of animals that are very important for helping people be able to have the food that they need to live. Number one, we have chickens, and they will provide us with protein, and then eventually with meat. The second animal that we have that's very, very important is goats. And goats will provide us with milk, with cheese, with yogurt. And so pretty much we're going to have everything we need with our fruit trees, with the nuts, with all of our vegetables for our biointensive garden. And now we're going to have protein that we need. So in order to take care of our animals, we're doing the same thing we've done with our garden. So could you guys tell me what are the four things that every creature needs to have?
Food,
water,
sunlight,
air. Right. And so we need to have a good protected place for our animals to live, right? And part of what we're doing is we want to make sure that anybody can do the same thing, that it's really affordable. So we're taking what is cast off, maybe that somebody else doesn't want, so that we can build this barn really, really inexpensively. So we have gotten donated from a local lumber store pallets that they use for putting tiles on and for carrying really heavy things. So we have enough of these, and we are going to figure out how to make a small barn area for our chickens. We'll make a little area that's shaded for them, because we want to make sure they're protected, right, for when it rains and so forth. And then they need to have a walking area so they have a good, peaceful place to live. That's number one. And then number two, then we'll figure out how to put their water in and their food. And then we're going to put our critters in. So we want to show people that you can do this so easily. So we have our wood. What we're going to be using to put this together is we went down to a local cleaner's and they gave us some cast off hangers. And so we're going to break this wire, so we're going to be able to hook our whole barn together with this wire. And we hope that that's all we're going to have to use. And then for protection on the top, we have a very inexpensive tarp, but it's very durable and it's airtight for the weather. And also we'll be able to hammer this down so it'll stay during storms. All right. Now let's go ahead and get started. Okay, you need to make sure that everybody, what you guys have on? Everybody has on their gloves, because this is rough wood and it's pretty splintery. And then we're going to all need to have our aprons on. And since it's supposed to be 101 today, 115, we've got to make sure that we have some kind of protection from the sun. So, all right, now, we have three sizes of pallets here. So we're going to start out with the small ones to build our basic enclosure. You guys want to come help me? Let's take out these four. We have four small pallets right here. Okay. And essence, you guys can figure out how to put those into the shape of like a little house. And we want to have this part of the house open, however. You want to get the edges and get these two? You know what? You want to get this one, Dave?
And you can put that over there and sort of make it like over here. Put that over there and then you put that alongside of that wall.
Okay, there's another one, girls.
Alongside that wall.
Where do you want this one?
Sienna. Now, all right. This, we're going to put our pond, our water purification pond, over in this area so we have enough shade here from our garden. But this should be pretty good. You know what? We have a longer one. Maybe we should put our longer one right along here. Let me see.
That one, I don't think she would make them up. We will do that right there.
Now.
Yes. They're attacking you.
What a mess.
It's working. All right. Now, Chinua has the very last one, and that one we're going to use for our gate. We're going to lean that against it. But let's get it closer. It leans against this. Good. Okay.
Chinua has the last one.
Chinua, carry it all the way around this way.
Yeah, I'll help him.
Go around the other, the long way.
Wait a second.
Now. You guys, we already have a little house and a fence. Not bad.
That's coming over here.
Okay. This is probably going to need to stand up, don't you think, a little bit more?
Okay,
so
we got
it.
Now, you know, this could be our gate right here because it's going to be easier to move. That can go against the wall. I think we have us a little house already.
But one left this little space.
Now this is going to need to be the door.
Right there or here.
Okay, you guys, look at this. Now what do you think? If this, let's get our opinions here.
So
you guys, look, if that's the space where they sleep, Essence, let me see. I think I have an idea of this. Okay, look, if this is going to be the gate that we open up, okay? Yeah. You know what?
Why are we doing that on top instead of...
Oh, cool. It's perfect.
Right, it'll stop
and
it.
Go right
because
underneath.
It's much more stable. They will put the tarp on top of it. You guys, look. Sure. Now, look what we have. We have a perfect little barn for them right there. And I'm
put,
thinking...
Put, like, hay right there.
Yeah. Okay. All right. We got the hay. Let's try it here.
Oh,
yes,
my gosh.
We do. Could everybody very carefully
thank you,
take
Heather.
It? Sorry, dear. It's a way of life. Okay, you guys. Everybody take... if we can get this cut about, so you don't have to hold it. We're going to wire it in a second.
This one,
the guys who are inside, take a little handful of this hay, a little bit, and spread it. Chinua, help us. Let's spread it around so they know this is their little barn area. And then what we have left, we'll make a nest out of for them. You guys, I think this is incredible. We already have a barn. Look at that.
Amazing.
Whoa. We've got us a barn. Woo. Now, let's leave the rest of it in there for a nest. I'll leave it right in there for a nest.
Heather's in hog heaven.
Hog heaven.
Hog heaven. Woo. Look at this. We've got a barn already. I love it. Okay, now I'm going to trust it. Now these kiddos here are going to figure out how we need to wire this together.
So it'll
this
stay
looks
close.
Like that Russian over in my
face. Look at that. We have a barn already.
Now wait a second.
There's
this
one down in my house. I do not know what this is called.
Okay.
Watch out for the gate, Glenna.
Okay. Miss Candace?
Yes.
Let's see. Okay, Nancy and Essence, could you guys put this over the top of that so that it's going to be totally protected?
I'm bringing.
Not my song.
Cheers.
Yay. Well, we know how you're
doing. Look at that. Mark? I cannot believe it.
Yeah.
Hey, snap.
You know, if anybody ever thinks building a barn is hard, how long did it take us to build this barn?
It just took us like 1 minute.
Probably about,
it didn't take very long.
10.
Maybe, well, yeah, right.
As long as you have these people to stand here forever.
And, well, this is what these are for. Then, what's amazing, you guys, it's now already, we have a barn, I can't believe it. Now, our next step is...
Getting marshmallows.
To put together, yeah, getting marshmallows. To cook. All right.
You breaking the wire.
Now, here's what we're doing, breaking the wire here. Okay, Edgar.
Make more wire, we break the wire.
Okay, well, let me show you first, sweethearts. Now... How many joints do we need to wire together? Okay, this one, we're going to be able to figure out how to get against the wall at some
one,
point.
The wood.
Okay.
Put it through the wood on the
two, three.
Yeah, you're right. That trellis.
We can put it
you
down
guys,
and
look.
Then hammer it.
Look, seven, you guys, look.
Five, six, seven,
now, you need to be careful so nobody gets hit
nine,
in the eye.
You need about 22.
When you, let's start out. When you bend it, it gets hot right at the bend, and that's how it breaks. The tensile strength of the wire...
New word, tinsel string.
That tinsel string.
Stand back up.
Do you ever notice they call string the bicycle's tinsel?
You guys, let's have our teacher, Miss Blitta, tell us what tinsel string is.
Well, it's the ability how many times you can bend something.
Right.
Before it breaks. You know, right. Some things you can bend forever, like a rubber band.
Right, exactly.
You can bend a rubber band forever, ever, ever, never break. But these
have a breaking point. Yeah, 8 times that it got really hot. Okay. Now,
so do you want that broken in half again?
Yes. Okay. I'm not sure. We're gonna need to leave it like that.
I think you don't need to break it again.
Candace, don't break it yet. Okay.
I think we need it that long to try.
Yeah. Okay.
Are we gonna have enough?
Like this.
Sort of like this.
If we have to get more, we can get more.
Sort of like that.
Now, plenty more where this came from.
That's okay. I want it to break. They want you guys.
Leave it. Only get it in half, you guys. Not.
Do you have one?
Not in force, only half.
Oh, do you have one?
You do it right here.
Okay. Yeah,
right,
Sienna.
It's okay.
No, the kids are supposed to do it.
You guys, this is good math because she needs to know that we're doing this right in half. We're not doing it in thirds, right in half. So if when you bend it,
you've
got to bend it right at the same spot. Now feel it with your thumb when you bend it, and you'll see it gets hot.
Where the wire?
And that's the point where the tensile strength is going to break down.
You've got to create more of a crease on it.
Edgar is now going to show us.
He's got strong hands.
Right here. Okay, the first joint we're going to put together are these two big ones. And Miss Glenna can put her two together right there.
What about this?
Okay, you go ahead with that one.
Yeah.
All right. Now let's see. Does anybody else have another half for us? Another half wire? Okay. Sienna, you want to come get this one right here?
Okay.
Right here. Yeah. Okay.
Miss Heather, how can I do this one?
Do
we have any more hangers?
No, if we have to get more, we'll get more.
It's too thick.
I think we'll need more.
Huh?
I think we'll need more.
Yeah.
To keep it, to make it sturdy.
Yeah.
And ideally, if you got longer or more, then you wouldn't have to break them. You'd be able to go around twice.
Yeah.
And really hold them together.
Now, okay. You want to get this joint that we're doing right here? Okay. See how it looks, babe. Now, Miss Candace,
short.
Can you come over here and help me get this one bent together?
Right.
I think you need to do it from the other side, sweetie, from the front. All right. Oops. Now, can you get a close-up on this, Bella? Because all she's doing, once you get the wire bent like 2 times, it's stiff enough. Yeah, you twist it. Good. And once you twist it, basically, too tight. Get this hook sticking out here.
Yep. We would do better with the using the whole hanger.
Can I show you? Yeah, we would, but it's okay. We don't have a whole hanger.
At least wire cutter.
So what we're doing
is twisting.
We're doing this low tech, dear. So we don't even need wire cutters. Here. Here's the technique. You got to get this like this. You get one going. You get one bent first. You need to start out with a
bend. How about if I hold there and you come do this? Excuse me, being as you know the technique.
You got to get up. You guys, you get a bend on each end.
Heather, let me hold here and you go over there and you do the technique.
Now look.
Go over there. I've got this. I'm holding.
We got a bend on each end, okay? You guys, you get a little hook. Could you listen for 1 second, sweetie? You get a little hook on each end. And then once you get the hook, then you can twist it around, but you do need to have your gloves because it's very, very stiff. Nancy, I've got this hook here. Can you twist this around?
Oh, I see what you're saying.
See? Okay.
You did it. Good girl.
Can you kind of twist that a little bit tighter?
A little bit
more. The other way, honey. You just unbend it. Good. Okay. Good. All right. She's twisting these two together.
Want this one?
Bending it?
Yeah.
Now we'll make this more sturdy later, but we just want to show folks. You can now look at that.
You need
okay?
To get some leather.
You guys look at that. Okay. Now, are you Angel? Let's do this one right here, babe. Okay. Now.
That's not real sturdy.
We'll make it sturdier later. Right now we're doing the basic structure.
Could make a gate hook.
Heather, where did you get these? I want to go get some more.
Yep, we'll get some more. Okay. And you know what we're finding out is that it's better with this width if you don't break your hangers in half. That's what we're finding out. So we're learning as we go. Okay, this one, we'll get another hanger, and we'll leave the whole hanger on there. In the meanwhile, this will hold it. Now let's go down to our next joint. Miss Glenda, do you need to put yours back together? Oh, sure. Okay, and actually now the last thing that we need to have, this one, if you could anchor that to the trellis there, this is not going to have a lot of stress on it. This one is only for our chickens.
So here, you didn't have to come around this.
You can pull up these measuring here.
This is not for her.
It goes to handle.
This is
the closest thing to.
Okay, look, I'm going to bend this together. Okay. Who has stronger?
Okay. This is like they do with the cow fences out in the backcountry.
Of course. That's where I grew up.
When you're going through in the back roads, you have to get out and open the fence and close it again. That's exactly what they do.
That's it.
Okay, sweetheart, you want to give me the... I think I'm going to turn it this way. Now, you know what? Okay, Sienna, you want to go get our chickens?
Can I get one?
Here, go and get our chickens, you guys. Could you get the water container? We have the, right there.
Right where?
Right by the cage, we have a water container.
Okay.
All right, sweetheart, you want to hold this up? All right, now I need to get this right in here. You want to hit this right here and then we'll screw it in. You guys, we already have a gate. I think this is pretty, pretty, pretty amazing.
And we got this one.
Is it this, Heather?
No, it's the red and white one. You know, did we take the chicken water thing over to the...
That's it.
That's it.
Okay, I'm going to move the chicken.
Water. All right.
Here's water.
There you go, Miss Glenna. Want to put water in the water container?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, we'll make this sturdier in a minute. Right now, we're just getting the basic techniques down. So, let's see. Angel, could you get, there's a food container that's inside that cage. Do you want to get the chicken scratch container for us? And you can fill it up with our chicken food.
Okay.
If this is on tighter, it won't leak out.
You know what? I can't believe we have a barn already. And isn't it amazing that everything is even? You know what? And they gave us three different sizes of pallets, and it totally worked out. Totally.
Okay, water's going in here.
Okay.
It's almost filled up.
Okay, are we ready, Bella? A really simple container for the... Did you get that, Bella? Should I start them again? Okay. Now we're filling up the really, really simple container for the chicken water. The thing that works with this, super simple. There's a little there's a little hole right here. When we turn this upside down, screw it in. You can do this with a jar, actually. You turn it upside down like this, and look, the water pours out, and then when the chickens drink it, there's always a source of nice clean water for them. Okay, you want to go ahead and put this over there in our barn?
We have them. Yeah.
You want to stand up, Bella, so you can see what you're doing. We already have a nest in their little protected area. There's their water. Now, where's the food?
Food.
Here.
Okay. Now, okay, Edgar?
Yes.
Edgar has the food. Come over here, sweetie pie. Now, this is basic, our chicken scratch. All this is broken up corn and oats and barley. So fill up our chicken food. There we have some. And so Nancy will now put over into our barn area.
Where the water is?
Mm-hmm. And then Edgar, because chickens really love to scratch around, you take some of that, Edgar, and throw it around like this. Honey, you want to go see where the chickens are?
Just scatter it with your hand, Edgar.
Yeah, good.
That's it.
They're going to love it. They are totally ready now. Isn't that amazing? Look, they're protected.
Ah, yes,
we've got a gate you can open. Isn't that incredible?
Yeah. Wonderful.
And, of course, we will make it more stable in a minute.
And I think it's cool how fast.
I know, I can't believe that. Quick, and you know what this cost us?
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing. We did borrow the hay from our other school.
Yeah.
And so, you know, like you don't have to have a fancy container for water. You can just have open container for water as long as you clean it out so you don't get algae in it. And you don't have to have a fancy container. You just use a can for your food. I mean, you got everything just exactly how you need it here. Now, Edgar, we need to put this. Let's get that other wire over there, the one that's on top of the chicken coop, because we need to attach this to our trellis.
So we're going to put the chickens in here before
Okay. So let's go ahead and attach this to the trellis there. All right.
I'll go on.
All right. Okay. Now they're attaching this to a trellis which is nailed to the wall. Okay. So we are now ready. All right. Oh, we have another wonderful student. Oh, Natasha. Hey. Oh, I'm so glad to see you.
We've been here for half an hour. We've been looking for you for 30 minutes.
Oh, I'm so glad you're here.
We've been here.
Natasha is a student from our other school, and she's going to be helping us out. Look, we already have a barn. We built this barn today.
We did it in 15 minutes.
Miss Candace, tell Natasha really fast in 15 minutes what we did.
We put the pellets up and we broke hangers. We straightened them out and now we're attaching them all together.
Isn't that neat?
And covered it.
Wait,
can
okay.
I? And here come the chickens.
This stuff in here needs to be like refrigerated a certain way.
They got Buffy.
Okay, you guys, look. Can we hold up one second?
Yes, wait,
you
might just. I'm out of room here.
I'm sorry. Okay, you guys, look who just came.
Can I go?
Oh, look.
Come on in with the stuff.
Oh, you guys, we've got Buffy. Let's see how they like their home. Natasha, go on inside. You want to go inside, Bella, so you can really see? Look, okay, Buffy's here. Okay, want to get a good shot of him there?
Close the gate.
All right. You want to, okay, we're going to close our gate. And this is how we're going to be attaching our gate with our one nail and a wire. And there they go. Edgar put down the chicken food already. Look at that. Look, Natasha, they have food, they have water, they have a nest back there. And when it rains, they have a completely enclosed little area. All right.
They're looking for the way out.
Now, this is what I call a barn. Woo!
Awesome!
Yay! Woo! All right. Thank you so much, sweetheart.
Oogie already likes it.
Look at him, he loves it. They're at home.
Yeah.
Isn't that neat?
They went for that right away, too.
Yeah, there they are. You know what I think, Edgar?
Love it.
You guys, look, I think we need to put this down so it's in the... Let's put the whole thing down so it case it rains. Help me to stretch it out. Yeah, we can't do that on that school.
Buffy's thirsty. Go show her where the water is. Don't catch the lens, Buff.
Look, just like it was, honey. Hold on to the back. Leave it
She's
right
thirsty.
Okay, ready, babe?
You want to pull it down the side, sweetheart? Yeah.
I don't know whose water
this
is.
Somebody pull it. Keep going out.
Looks like mine, but it's probably in everybody's room.
Hey, Natasha.
Did she get a drink, Buffy?
Glenna has your lunch. Try to put it in the cafeteria.
Look at her feet.
You're not going to get to stay with us?
No, I can't. I have an appointment. I have to pick up my 3 years dad. Okay.
Look at this, you guys. I have a totally enclosed house now. Look at that.
Can I go back there?
Yeah, just don't stick your face in the rooster.
Is it down now?
Uh-huh.
Look at that. We have a barn.
Sienna. Sienna.
All right. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and get everything all cleaned up. Let's put away our aprons. And everybody put away their gloves. Look at them, they're happy there. Isn't that neat? Miss Nichols is
already drinking
she?
Water.
She's in the office.
They're already drinking water. Oh,
yeah. Look at them, you guys.
They know that it looks
they
like they're home.
They recognize their
bowl. Isn't that wonderful?
Good girl, Buffy.
Yep. Good girl. And is there real? Yep.
Good girl, Buffy.
Isn't that neat?
Good girl, Buffy.
Hey,
Buffy.
Okay, sweetie pies, there you go. Pretty. I'm amazed.
Threw it at me.
Okay. Sorry, Bella. Drink up, Buffy. Let's just pretend that this is like the barnyard with the chick, chick, chicky, and he scatters some out. You can because they love to scratch. And while they're scratching, they're going to be eating bugs and other sorts of protein for them. Okay? So that's what they do with the food each time. Okay. Now, another thing that they have to have each time is what?
Water.
Okay. So, okay. So we know what our water thing looks like, that container that comes out. Okay. So each time you go out there, you are going to have to put, you have to pour some water in your bowl. Now, if the bowl happens to be dirty, sometimes about once a week, their water does get a little bit dirty. So if you look in there and the water looks dirty, the next job that you have to do is we're going to have a brush, and the brush will stay right on the shelf. So let's pretend there's like some dirt in the edge. So Edgar's going to take the brush now. He's going to brush it out. And then, Natasha, you want to rinse it out a little bit more. Okay. Then you can put a little bit more water in after you brush the algae off. And then you shake it around like this. And then you can pour this water, the water that has the algae in, you can pour it right back onto the ground, because you're not going to put the dirty water back into the container for the animals. Okay? Good. Now, in the next job that you have to do, is that food and water, right? So every morning when we go in, that's what we're going to do. Now, these are our brushes, and they stay right in these containers. Now, later on, we're going to be having goats. And with chickens, up on their head where they have their small feathers, they like it when you do like this on them. Like that? That's part of loving them. Yeah? Okay, so pretend that my arm is a chicken head. So just do a real gently. Good. Okay, we've got chicken head. You have Buffy there. You've got Oogie on my hand. Try it. Pretend my hand is his head. You're going to do it really, really gently. Yeah, and they love it. Because they can reach all parts of their bodies, but of course their beak right here, they can't get their neck parts. And that's why they really like all birds, when you have tame birds, they like to have their neck and their head brushed. Okay? Good. Then when you're all done with the brush, Natasha, show us what you do with the brush when you're all done. Exactly. And then on the shelf that's right behind the barn, you always put this right back on the shelf, the same place where you're going to be putting the food, right back in the same place all the time. Now, the next thing that we need to do, okay, once in a while, we need to totally rake up all the hay. Once a week, we're going to rake up all the hay that's in their barn. Let's pretend this is going to be the barnyard right here, okay? I'm going to hold this for me, Spirit. Okay? Can you sprinkle out very gently some of the hay on our barnyard? Sprinkle, 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 sprinkle. Yeah, you only have to have a really thin layer of it. Okay? Now, let's pretend this is the rake. Alright? And we're going to have a bucket just like this that has clean hay in it. And then you'll have another bucket that you're going to use when you rake up all the hay that's been used once a week. So now, you rake up that hay from our barnyard and put it into the bucket that has the old hay in it. Good. Here. And now, since we don't waste anything at all in our whole barnyard, in our whole garden area, what would we do with this hay that has a little bit of chicken poop on it? Exactly, with the compost.
Because, you know, when we talked the other day about our worm farm, the absolute most, the most, the best kind of fertilizer is what? The worm poop and worm castings. Okay? The second kind of best fertilizer, any farmer will tell you that, is guess what?
Chicken
poop. Okay? It doesn't have any protein in it. It doesn't really smell. And if you guys should accidentally step on it, you got to remember, Miss Bella's saying, don't panic because it's organic. So, we have outside the barn, I always have a plastic mat. So if you accidentally get a little bit of chicken poop on yourself, when you walk out the door, you always go, 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't get dirt on the splinter's floor. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't get dirt on the splinter's floor, right? Okay, so, but don't worry about it, you guys, because you'll, by the time you walk back into class, if you wipe off your feet and walked on the grass, you're going to be really clean. So, you take this over to our compost pile, you spread it out in the compost pile, and there's always the rake right by the compost pile. You can take the rake and, like, flip it into the compost. Now, once in a while, remember the covering that we put over our garden? And you put that on there because it's going to keep the moisture underneath. If you see that that's already turned to compost, and you need to have a little bit more of this on your garden, you can very carefully, with your glove, you can take a little bit of this, take your hand shovel. Yeah. Just pretend you never. Or you can take the glove, because you're going to wash your glove, okay? Then you take a little bit of this and spread out very gently again over the top of your garden so you can have your protection. So, we're not wasting anything at all. Alright? So once a week, that's what you do. But every day you give them water. And every day you give them... Yep. Okay. Yes, Natasha. What happens to the compost? The compost actually, as the little microbes, as they eat it, okay, the compost, if the pile is this big, by the time the compost wake up, they say, ah, look at that carbon and look at that nitrogen. And they go chop, chop, chop. The compost actually becomes smaller and smaller and smaller because it compacts down into soils. So whenever the compost is all nice and brown and nice soil, then we take the compost, we get it with our shovel, and we take it back in our garden at various times. So it goes like this. Put out your finger, you know what happens. Everything runs in circular motion. Life is like a dance between air and sea. Everybody is a part of everything anyway. Nature shows a way to set us all free, to give and receive, life to give and receive, life. Now, you guys, for sure you know when you're all done. So then, now you've done all these things. You scattered out the hay. You cleaned up the hay. You brushed your animals. You gave them food. You gave them water. You gave them some love. So now you're all done, so what do you need to clean up? What's the last thing you have to do? Right. And that means you got to put away your... Go ahead, take off your gloves, sweetie. And then what's the last thing you got to do with your aprons? Show us how you fold your aprons right in front of you.
Here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just sit down, right?
You want some chicken soup?
Right?
It's been touched by chickens or metal ears.
Can we go in the barn?
Ew.
Yeah.
I'm just
saying. You guys going fun.
Did you see that Joel is painting this? Do not touch the chicken.
Elizabeth?
Okay,
guys. Are we ready now?
Listen for directions.
Okay. I'm going to show you guys several things that we have in the cage. First, this is called a rabbit hutch. Can you say that?
Rabbit hutch.
Right. It has a screen. Can you say that? Screen?
Screen.
And the screen's down here at the bottom. And then here we have, this is their water container.
Water.
And then here's what we do. Oh, they need to have water. Did someone bring my... I had my...
Water pitcher?
No, I had that blue water pitcher.
Oh.
Thank you, dear.
You're choking my...
Look, when you come in, you can fill up their water.
You want hot water?
Then you take the lid and you go like this. Who knows which way you turn it when you close it up?
Oh,
it goes
right.
Righty-tighty. You know that? Righty-tighty.
And lefty.
Now, if I'm
going
to open it up, it's lefty-loosey. But right now, it's righty-tighty. I close it all the way up. You take it upside down. Look at the ball, you guys. See? Isn't that neat? Listen to the sound. They push it with their tongue, and the water comes out. So when you put it here, we have to make sure it's standing up straight, okay? Alrighty. There you go. Now, Miss Bella bought them a little treat. They don't really need this, but this they that they really like. It looks like corn, right? Now, we need to have food for them, right? Now, remember, these are those, that's like the little hay. It's all ground up like pellets, okay? When you come in here to help them, look what you can do, kiddos. You can take food. You can put food right here. In that little food container. See? Now, so they have water and they have food, but they need something else.
Hay
to get really, really comfortable. So later on, I'm going to have a couple of bales of hay in here, right about there. But you can take some hay and put it right in there. So until I get my bales of hay, we'll pretend that this is hay right here, my bales of hay. And you put it right inside for them, okay? Now, shall I put the rabbits in there? Are they ready now?
Yeah.
Come on, bunnies. Oh, one thing you also can do whenever you come in. Yep, you can pet them. But look at this. What is this, you guys? It's a brush. Look what I can do. Very gently. Would you like it? Would you like it if I hit you in the eye with the brush?
No.
They don't like it either, so watch what you can do. Look. I love your bunny bunnies. You can pet them very gently. They like that. You can brush them very, very gently. However, the roosters have feathers. Do you brush the roosters?
No.
Only these guys with the fur. But when you're all done, brush. Your brush goes right in this caddy. And the brush goes right up here, okay? Now, let's put the rabbits in there. They're ready with their brushes. They're ready with their food. They're ready with their water. Oh, come on, half and half. Come here, baby. Come on, baby. Oops, come on, butterscotch. Come on, butterscotch. Come here, guys. Come here, baby. Come here, baby. Come on. Come on, half and half. Come on, half and half. There you go. So we can get right here in this cage.
Oh, he's a hot.
Come on, baby. There you go. Okay, so they have everything they need. Now, for our chickens. Now, our chickens are going to be out running around. So they have a different water container. We need to give them fresh water all the time. So here's what you do. You don't need to pick up their water container. We're going to get water from we'll have a pitcher for them. We get water over there at the faucet. Bring it here. There you go. Now, I am going to also have a bin right here that has all of the chicken food in it.
Butterscotch.
So, from the Joel, would you mind getting that bag of chicken food right around the corner there? Sorry, it's right over there. So, for our rabbits, by the way, we can have another container of rabbit food. They can have their rabbit food outside, or they can have it inside their cage. Now, who else is going to bring us here? A big container of
chicken.
Yeah, the chicken. Okay. Now, I'm going to have a big bucket right here. Could you bring it both? Joelle, would you mind? Okay. I'll have a big bucket with a cover on it. Now, this is our broken up corn. And in this big bucket, we came back out. In this big bucket, you guys.
This is half to half.
It's okay. You can take take the corn, put some in their container. The container will be right here. But let me show you what chickens love to do. Remember what we said about their little claws? You can take some corn and go like this. Chick, 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 chick. Because they love the scraps. Now let's let these guys out. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. Okay, they like that better. Now, right here where these cages are, this time I have the bales of hay right where these cages are. So, I'm going to open this up so they can hop out when they want to. And then here we have another little container of food. We'll put it right back in here. So when you guys come, one of my students gave these little baby toys in case they want to peck on it.
Dummy pattern?
Uh-huh.
Each class will have a schedule for feeding, right? You can't just feed them if you want to, right? You have to have...
They'll feed them when they come out with me.
Right.
Yeah. So, guys, the rule is the only time you guys get to come in the barn is when you're with me. You don't just come out all the time, okay? Because one class is going to feed them one day, one class will feed the next day, and then your class will divide you up into three. Whenever I take you out, this is what you do. We'll do all kinds of nice activities outside, but you guys can all come in the barn when I take you out only. And then you do all these things. You water, you feed all the critters. Okay? And you can pet them. Pardon? About you found a rabbit?
Yeah.
Tell us a story about your rabbit. You guys, somebody put this in here, and you know what? Chickens aren't used to eating fruit, so what we're going to do is any leftovers you have from school, you can give bread or you can give vegetables, and we'll put them in a special bucket. Every day, a special bucket, and I'll save lunch scraps on this bucket, and then after lunch, we'll bring it in here, you leave it right, no, you're right, no paper, no plastic, no meat, and we'll leave it right here, and the chickens will love it, but we don't put sweet things, we don't put meat, and we don't put paper or plastic, candy, no.
Not cookies.
You're not going to have worms for lunch, I don't know. Three things to do when you come in here. Feed the rabbit, number one. Okay, and you want to say this after me? Number two.
Number two.
Feed the chickens.
Feed the chickens.
Number three.
Number three.
Recycle your lunch.
Recycle your lunch.
Number four.
Number four.
Love the chickens.
Love the chickens.
Number five.
Number five.
Love the rabbits.
Love the rabbits.
Okay, all right, you guys, you are wonderful. We got
to
wait. Oh, let's have a song. I'm right here.
I think Ethan rises. Ethan
very. Right there.
Okay, let's hear the chicken side. Good, let's hear it.
Virginia.
Okay, let's hear it.
And
with
a chicken. Chicken out of clothes. I went to the well to wash my clothes. When I got
Okay. Oh, isn't it a bit of luck that I was born a baby chick with yellow socks and yellow shoes, so I may go wherever I choose. Now clap. Yay!
Move out of the way.
All right, they love that song. Now they're happy. What? Look, you want to see the rabbits one more time?
Yeah.
Okay. Half and half and butterscotch, hopping through the schoolyard, looking for some carrots that they can eat. Because they love lettuce and they love carrots. And they love Miss Betty's nuts because you're so sweet. Okay.
Well, that.
Good job, you guys.
Okay.
Good job,
you
guys.
If you have blue shirts on, you may go line
next
up at the
time
door.
When I come and pick you guys up.
If you have white shirts on, you may line up at the door.
Now, my day with them is Monday. Okay. On Monday, we'll do all this stuff,
you
guys.
If you have purple shirts on, you may line up at the door.
Now I'm gonna do a big one.
You guys are never looking in these pots.
Okay. Found one. I found one. Okay, put it in there.
Yeah.
I don't want a lot of these. That's good. Yeah. Guys, if you want some more, come over here. You have to cut them off.
Buffy has about one more week. All of her eggs are getting ready to hatch. Look at her. She has not gotten off of that nest for 2 weeks. Isn't she being a good mama?
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Now, you guys, Butterscotch has two brand new babies in there. Listen, Patrice. You guys. Oh, little goatee. She has three brand new babies, and they need to be very, very quiet. She's very young. I think that might be why she's outside. Because do you think her babies need to be nursed?
Yeah.
Because they're mammals, right? And baby mammals need to have milk from their mama.
Yeah.
So she goes in there. I saw her in there this morning. But we can't go into this cage because we don't want to scare Buffy and we don't want to scare Butterscotch.
Hey, Butterscotch.
Well, can we take you guys, look, there's something I want to show you. Very interesting. Do you see some Butterscotch's fur?
Yeah.
Do you see?
Yeah,
that's one shedding. Way. She's very little. It was hard to tell she had three babies in her tummy. But one way you can tell is looking for some lettuce to eat. Because she loves lettuce and she loves carrots. And she loves lettuce like you're so sweet. You guys, now, you guys who were running over there, you didn't hear what I said about the rabbits. Could somebody please tell?
May